The socket should be around here. There it is! Huh? The Overlord's plug is gone!
Ha ha! Looking for something, dearie? No use, no use, no use!
Who's there?
Hey, fellas, the power plug is over here.
Another kind of Sir Mal?
Well, this one seems kind of high-strung.
Yes, yes, yes! That's right. I'm a clone of Mal. I won't let you re-scar my heart, savvy?
Why don't you want to be back to normal?
Why, you ask? Take this! Hoorah!
No!
Now, didn't that hurt?
Of course, you psycho!
Right, now listen up. Scarring hurts. Only special kinds of people like pain. Normal people don't want to hurt. So you see, it's Mal's wish not to be scarred again. For a happy ending. It's for his happiness, gent and lady.
That's true. Putting the trauma back into his heart will make him have to suffer his burden all over again.
Understand now? If you do, then get out! Scram!
Wait, that ain't true! Oh, that dignified yet cutesy voice.
Beryl?
A scar hurts, so what? That's just an excuse to run away. Where's the happiness in that?
Miss Beryl.
The Mal I know isn't a weakling who'd run away just because it hurts. You're a clone of Mal, yet you don't even know that?
No, shut it! Don't talk as if you know me, you stranger!
Mal and I are enemies and friends. We're not strangers in the least. We've got a bond as rivals.
She's right. Mal would never want to go on like this. Mal is arrogant and selfish and makes me cringe and gets excited over bizarre experiments. You're not the real Mal.
Bamboo!
Well said, both of you. Sir Mal is pleased as well.
Ah, freaking A! What would you know? Only I know Mal's true thoughts! I won't let anyone interfere. I will personally guard Mal's heart and keep it tightly locked as is.
Ugh, looks like it's impossible to solve this one through negotiations. But I can't give up here, or else it'd be meaningless of me to have boycotted my precious class.
Did you say boycott? Speaking of which, today's class, who cares about me? More importantly, get Mal to... Oh, Our Lady has ditched a class for the first time since school began. How is this going to set an example? Oh, Kyoko, you dummy! Don't you think it's even more delinquent to rush to a rival's aid than to go to class? Girls, after all those times I told you not to come after me!
Miss Beryl, you really do care for Mal.
Mabu!
My rival's in this situation. I can't just sit around watching. Though, I lost my perfect attendance.
I wouldn't say that's true.
A mixture of various spices combined to form an aromatic symphony? Curry? Which means, could it be?
No need to worry about your perfect attendance.
Master!
Razberyl, number one delinquent of the academy. You girls shall become the first ever graduates in school history.
Graduates?
You dudes went to class so much, you've got enough units to graduate already. Or something, dude.
But they haven't even attended the school for a whole year.
The Academy figured the best way to get rid of them was to give them what they want. Full academic completion, dude.
So that's it. Care to relish in the delicacy of the season? We will now commence graduation.
And now, the farewell speech. Always kind to everyone. We're Miss Beryl and friends. We were invited to volunteer work. And we're very annoyed. The end. Dude.
Wasn't that a little short?
Next up is our reply speech. Let's do it, Kyoko, Asuka. On this glorious and unlucky day,
we look back on our lives like the flashbacks before our deaths.
A teacher was eaten
during a field trip.
We watched blood vessels pop
during athletic events.
On orientation day,
we found a mummy of a student.
We will hold dear our memories at this school and prepare to depart.
Please watch over us from within your graves.
representing the graduating class, Razzbarrel.
Such a perfect reply address, as if it was practiced routinely.
Of course it was! We trained rigorously for the day when we might be able to graduate.
Graduation speech practice within months of starting school? Such peculiar preparation! I should learn from you! Evil Academy's first graduating class, Razzbarrel! You fulfilled your units to graduate, surprisingly. Congratulations! And the same to the rest of you. Here are your graduation diplomas. Take them while they're fresh.
This is the graduation diploma I've always dreamed of. We've accomplished an achievement no one has ever done.
My lady, we no longer have classes or curfews. We're free to save others to our heart's content.
Your perfect attendance shall continue to shine radiantly throughout the history of this school.
There shouldn't be any leftovers now. We leave the rest to you, Razzbarrel.
Yes, I have no regrets now. Mal, I'll turn you back to normal.
Ba-bloo!
No! I won't let you!
You were waiting during the whole graduation ceremony? That was awfully considerate of you.